So today, I'm going to show you how to upload items to Firebase and download those uploaded items using their download URL. So without wasting time, let's jump into it. The first button here, I'll use to pick any file from the internal storage. We'll pick files using the file picker component. This second button will be used to upload the file that was picked. I'll use a progress bar to see the uploading process as it goes on. This text view at the top will show the percentage of the upload process. I'll use the list view to get all the items I just uploaded. What you have to do first is to create a file picker component. Select your MIM type, depending on what type of files you are uploading. Add your Firebase details first, before you do anything else. After adding all your Firebase details, create a Firebase component. The data location here is the storage path you want your data to be stored. It is like a pathway where data is specifically kept for simple analysis. So let's write a storage path to help us know where the data is stored in the database. Next, create a Firebase storage component. We'll use it to upload files to Firebase. Our storage path is going to be upload / items. Go to events, then create a component event called onFilesPicked. We'll use this event to set any action once a file is picked. Create a string variable called file. We'll use it to store the file that was picked. Create another string variable called fileName. It will store the name of the file that is picked. Use the block get segment path to get the name of the file. Go to the first button's onClick event and drag the file pick block in it. In the second button's click event, start by adding this condition block. I will check if the file string is empty. If it is, I will ask the user to pick a file. The upload block requires a file for successful uploading. Insert both the file string and the file name string if the upload block is required. Go back to events and create a new event called onUploadProgress. We'll use this event to see the uploading progress of the file. I'll set both the text view and the progress bar to show the uploading progress. Next, create an event called onUploadSuccess. We'll use it to upload the file name and the download URL in Firebase database. We'll start by showing a toast message to inform the user that the upload is complete. After that, create a map variable to use for uploading to Firebase database. The putKey blocks will be used to add keys and values to retrieve them later on list view. I'll input download URL as key, because I'm adding the download URL as the value. I'll do the same with file, because my value is a file. Use the push value block below it to push all these values to Firebase. then add clear map block below. It isn't a necessary step though. Let's go back and add another component event called onChildAdded. I'll get all values I uploaded to the list view, using the block getChildrenToListener. For this to work, we must create a listener. Let's go to view, and drag the list view block that sets data using listener. Next, I'll go to onEventEvent. But first, I must connect the list view. This is the custom view. I'll get the name of the file in this text view. I'll use this button to download the file in a specific position. After connecting to the custom view, the onEvent event will appear. First, we'll start by checking if the listener contains the key file. We'll continue by creating a string variable that will get the name of the file. Use the block get segment path of twice inside the string. Next, use this block to execute the download button click listener. Inside the block, we'll check if the download URL exists. So, if the download URL exists, I'll use the download block to download the file. Use the block get external storage directory to direct a file in your specific folder. To see the progress of the file that is downloading, add an event component called onDownloadProgress. I'll still use the text view and the progress bar to show progress. Lastly, we'll use onDownloadSuccess to show a toast that the download is complete. At onCreate, get all the items from Firebase to your listener. This will get all the data in your list view every time the app is opened. Before we compile the project, make sure you change some rules in Firebase. First, go to real-time database and change all the rules to true. After you've set all your rules to true, open the drawer and click on Storage. Click on Rules here. Then, click Edit Rules. Delete this part of the line. Then write true, just after it. Then click Publish. Now, we are ready to compile the project. We'll click Pick File to choose any file from the storage to upload to Firebase. But if we haven't picked any file, the Upload button will only show this toast missed. We selected the file, now let's upload it to Firebase. If your internet connection is weak, the uploading progress will take longer. Once the upload is done, the file name that was uploaded will add to this list view here. Let's download the file, and see if it will save to the download file in my storage. Here is the screenshot we uploaded. it's successfully saved to downloads. We come to the end of the video, I hope you enjoyed watching. If you learned something, please smash a like and share it to others. I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe.